Dear friends, welcome to RPA Tutorials. In this video, we bring you the first stage of the RPA automation framework, which is process selection. In this phase, we will see how businesses can identify and prioritize processes eligible for automation. Before that, let us have a relook at which type of processes are suitable for automation and can be shortlisted for further analysis. A suitable process must be rule-based, that is, it must have a defined logic. It should be stable and functioning. Processes with high transactional volume. And it needs to be digital with digital triggers. Any kind of human physical work cannot be automated through RPA. Once you have shortlisted suitable processes, the next step is to select which ones to automate. The process selection stage consists of two steps: process benefit analysis and process prioritization. In process benefit analysis, an organization has to list and weigh its business priorities based on its focus areas. These focus areas could be saving manual labor hours and repurposing employee time, improving quality through error reductions, improving customer satisfaction, streamlining mission-critical processes, and adhering to regulatory framework. The next step is to prioritize these focus areas. For example, saving manual labor hours has a direct impact or reduction overhead costs, enables businesses to grow without increasing headcounts, and frees up employees from labor-intensive, repetitive and tedious activities so that they can now focus on innovation and value-added tasks. Hence the weightage assigned to this parameter can be as high as 50%. Similarly, assign weights to other focus areas and weigh them according to their relative importance to your organization. The next step is to prioritize the shortlisted processes based on the focus areas identified. Let us examine three processes, A, B, and C. In order to calculate the dollar savings for each of these processes, we need to calculate manual labor hours saved by automating these processes. For example, in process A, if there are two personnel involved in the process, who work 2 hours every day, for 20 days in a month, 12 months in a year, and their cost is $100 per hour, then the annual dollar saving for process A is $96,000. Similarly, for process B it could be $80,000, and process C it could be $120,000. Rank the other business priorities on a scale of 0 to 5. 0 to 1 could mean no or insignificant business priority, 2 to 3 indicates medium priority, and 4 to 5 indicating high business priority for that process. Next step is to calculate a business goal alignment percentage. Use the weights defined for each of the focus areas defined earlier to calculate the same. The aggregate percentage calculated shows a closer alignment of process A to organization's existing business priorities. Some organizations also take absolute dollar savings as the primary driving factor for prioritizing processes for automation. In this case, process C would then be prioritized over others for automation. Processes which do not align to existing business priorities and are low on dollar savings can be deprioritized and taken up at a later stage, like process B in this case. This brings us to the end of this video. If you like our videos, subscribe to our channel below, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter and connect with us on LinkedIn. Links in description below.